there you are. Ready for the great formula? Ready as I'll ever be, I guess. Yes, that's what I wanted to hear. Attention, take your place. Here we go. What's my place? Birobolos Kovala Alamente, or something. Okay, you made an earthquake. What the? What the hell? Balor? Damn mortals! Who do you think you are? Gnomes! Always just gnomes! I will tear you apart for that! Can one not expect to get a human offering from one's followers? Or a dwarf? A human offering. Followers? But we are no followers. What do you mean? Are you not acolytes of my abyssal powers? But why did you send me the gnome, then? We have sent no gnome. He has tried the great formula. Formula? What kind of formula? What are you talking about? Tell him the story of Carlini. Carlini, yes? This name is all too familiar to me and hated. I think I understand now. This foolish Carlini found the magic formula, which was otherwise used to offer a sacrifice to me. Ha 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 ha! Instead of understanding what happened, he made himself my slave! Ha ha ha! If this was all just a stupid mistake, why do you not just send the gnomes back? Silence, mortals! My anger is not appeased. For almost 100 years now, I had to endure that damn Carlini with his scientific delusion. He constantly had to ask questions and investigate things. I'm sick of him. I need a slave worthy of me. However, there is the agreement for only one slave per invocation. One soul is already under my domination. This other silly gnome. Listen, elf. I offer you to release the two gnomes in return for your soul. Return for your soul. You can forget that. Well, if this is your last word, so be it. The deal is made and cannot be undone. Excuse me now, I have to torture some gnomes. Oh, there is one more thing. The deal says you would get a gift from me. I would be happy. This is an appropriate item worth a gnome soul. Okay, there's definitely an item there. I don't think we could have defeated that. We oversaw the casting of the spell, but surprisingly a Balor appeared and Ygnatius vanished. Unexpectedly, the fiend agreed on letting the two gnomes go for my soul in exchange. I refused the offer, and the Balor vanished into thin air. You didn't want to take that thing to take my soul. Sorry, Carlini, what is this? A medium shield. And a bear somewhere. Well, guess we didn't lose reputation for that. No. Oh. We did actually take a place around, but...
Sure.
Sorry, guy. What could we do? I don't think we could have fought that thing. I mean, maybe. I don't know how hard it is to defeat a Balor, but... must be pretty hard, pretty difficult. You still gotta find Prism. And this takes place in Baldur's Gate. This is just something. More scalps, yeah, I gotta turn those in. I witnessed an ambush at the coastway. It's in Baldur's Gate. Because I killed him already. I don't know if I'm supposed to return to her. This is... Yeah, I guess... I think that takes place in Baldur's Gate as well. That's just east of the bridge to Baldur's Gate. The mage is on his way to Baldur's Gate. As I flooded the mine. Ogre encampment I took care of. Oh, am I supposed to return? Oh! I'm supposed to return to him. He was up top. Dinah here says, "Thou art a caravan master, Kagan?" "Nay, my business be to see to a caravan safe travel." "Hast thou traveled with caravans?" "Aye, here and there. I studied many maps, but I have not heard of a country named here, and for that matter, neither I came across there." "So what? Go study your scroll some more. Maybe you'd find it. By Moradin's hammer, beardless wench, do you know when to leave a fightin' man alone?" "Thou art uncouth. No respectable dwarf would go answering some mage's stupid questions for hours, and that's still not enough for you." "By my reckoning, no respectable dwarf would wander the land away from his clan, either." "You betcha he would. Now stop tempting me axe, wench. It'd be thirsty for blood." I love it. I think I'm just gonna head back to Ulcaster.
"You have been waylaid by enemies and must defend yourself.
But first kill gibberlings."
"My blade will cut you down to size."
Brother. Scroll of color spray.
"I need an ale."
"Go for the eyes, Boo! Go for the eyes!
Oh my.
"Whatever then, as well as I can."
Which one are you? That's Imowen.
"Do they wish my ear?"
Alright.
"Their call as directed." "As well
go
as
for the eyes, Boo! Go for the eyes! Rask!"
"As well as I can." "Tempest, give us victory!"
"My blade will cut you down to size."
"M. No less."
Link's eye gem.
"I don't want to talk."
"No
Tempest,
less done.
Give us victory." "My blade will cut you down to size."
Actually damaging us, damn.
"I must rest."
"Vita, mortal,
I'm tired.
Vita, mortal."
Okay. Hopefully this will be good enough. I just want to return.
All right.
There, we need to talk to what's his name again. Maybe he would want that body.
All right.
I don't remember hearing that humming, that weird sort of groaning humming sound. I forgot all about him, that he was up here waiting. So he's probably going to want that book of his. It's really just the Sisters of Light and Darkness. Maybe that's his body. Doesn't say whose body it is, just a male body. But you know what? Where is he? Did he move somewhere else? Bold.
Alright! Give us victory!
Why me?
Where did the guy go? Why couldn't he just stay out here where he was? Oh wait, here he is. Just in case. Knowledge returns with these simple words on parchment. To teach once more in a celestial class. I will prevent the same from happening someday. And one says, to think all he wanted was a book so he could teach. Makes you kind of wonder. Oh, Sapphire, you'll get whatever I want so I can rest in peace if I die, right? I'll get whatever I want so I can rest in... Okay. Farewell. When I presented the ghost of Ulcaster with one of his lost books, he seemed to regain some of his frayed sanity. Oh, Tamar rescued. Young Tamar fell prey to a basilisk's... Basilisk, actually, petrifying gaze. I was happy to rescue her. Quest for Purwell. Okay, she's searching for her son herself. Okay, Magnificent Coralini. Yeah. What do I do with this body? Up 185 pounds.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Take this body, will you? We all shall live again someday. Don't you growl at me like that. I helped you. No growling. All right then. No sudden moves. You're a spooky little guy, aren't you?
Why me?
Oh, Dinah here leveled up. Didn't even notice. That got reduced by one. Additional mage spells. Okay, and got another level 2 spell and 2 more level 4 spells. 6 more hit points. Good. She needs that. Lore increased by 3. Good. So, what do we want? We already have Blur, which you don't use. Mel's Acid Arrow, which you don't use. Stinking Cloud, which you hardly ever use. Maybe I'll just have a spare Identify. Or we just find one thing. Ah, she needs to learn some... She needs to get some level 4 spells. Definitely. Because she can memorize
As
them.
As directed.
She doesn't have any.
Sure.
Where are we going?
Sure.
By Valkor's mighty blade.
Sure.
I can just go out this way, be the quickest probably. Oh, what we got? Oh, hobgoblins. I don't think we found hobgoblins here before. Zircon gem.
What is it?
Oh, is she poisoned? She is poisoned.
What is your command?
Moonstone gem.
What?
I said a moonstone gem. And a scroll of shield. And folder. If we can't find out what to do with this body, we're gonna have to stow it somewhere. And hope it stays there.
Why me?
So,
why me?
You want some whiskey?
Why, you don't want to buy a male body? Talking about $0. Well, I gotta turn these scalps in. You can sell scalps, but not an entire body. Something's wrong with that. Tell me, hurry up. Alright, so... I don't have anything... Ooh, I gotta identify this thing. I didn't think that would work.
All right,
resting. See, here we don't get scattered, so we can't rest. Okay, medium shield. Mirror shield, plus one. The shield is polished to a high gloss and obviously magical. Scratches... disappear? Yeah. And blood and dirt simply run off its reflective surface. It can be presumed that it can even withstand the look of a basilisk. I would think it would then. This wearer is protected against all types of petrification and forms of gaze attacks. Plus one bonus to armor class as well. Requires 12 strength. Sweet, alright. Plus one bonus. This would bring her armor class down to 2, though, by 1, I mean. I think I might just give it to her to use. In case we run across more basilisks or anything that petrifies or paralyzes. Petrification, forms of gaze attacks. Because I do that, and now her armor class is... Oh. Still 0? Oh wait, no, I'm looking here. Armor class 3. Where should I be looking? My guess is it's not stacking or something. I don't know. I'm not sure. Now this is her effective armor class is minus 1 and... So that's 1. So it's the same with this. I might as well just use that. Yeah, sounds good. Alright, so she's got this mirror shield from a demon. Beam shield plus 1. Plus 1, same. Yeah, okay. Alright, so let's sell one of these medium shields plus 1.
Go pester someone else. Sure.
Just sell the shield and shut up. Assuming, no, we won't buy it.
Yes. Okay.
Back to sleep, and then we'll...
I need an L.
Go to Thunderhammers.
Why me?
time is it? 6 a.m.? Is he open yet?
All right.
Not completely sure.
All right.
Says rest again. Take a load off and all that stuff.
Why me?
So now it's... yeah. 2 p.m. So we're gonna sell the shield. And I think there's something else we can sell. Did figure out what to do with the body, actually. Oh, and then we can sell this stuff. I'm gonna do that off screen.
A simple matter.
Sure.
In we go.
I can make whatever you wish for a wee little bit more than me competition.
Yeah, it's that side. There you go.
All right. Sure. Why me?
Okay, we're getting stuck. The red sheaf. Silk. Yeah, I don't know what use he's waiting for.
Sure. All right.
I gotta find somewhere out of the way where I can store this body.
All right.
How do I get in there? I don't know if I can walk through that.
Less talk, more fight.
No fighting.
Ricky wheel gets the kick.
Will it fit? All right. So we've stored it in there. Commoner, you saw nothing. You know it's good for you. No, we didn't kill him. Well, we don't know what to do with him right now, and I have a feeling someone's gonna be looking for him. Maybe if we had the body...
You do-gooders always make me wanna vomit.
We do-gooders. We just took a dead body and surreptitiously stowed it in a sack. We could have turned it into the authorities, but no, we're hoping somebody's been looking for it. You know, I'm wondering... Well... That one shade of a wizard who wanted to take one of our bodies. He wanted a live body. Well, I wonder if things would have turned out differently if we had the body with us. Maybe he would have inhabited that body? I don't know. I don't know what the body's all about. Because I don't see anything else. I don't see anybody looking for a dead person right now. It's something that might come up later. I have no idea. I'll try to remember. Yeah, this is where I put them. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.